Russell McKenzie, I farm on the Bedfordshire-Cambridgeshire border. We farm just under 995 hectares, all predominantly cereals with some break crops, winter wheat, winter and spring barley, spring oats, also rape and beans. We've got quite a diverse rotation now compared to what we had a few years ago. We've been predominantly 2 weeks in oilseed rape, and that's been driven by black grass as much as anything. So what we've got on this field here, this is after an oilseed rape crop which we harvested back in July. And we had a look at doing this a couple of years ago about putting a short-term cover crop mix in. The idea being is that it will hopefully in a wet sort of season like we've got now, drag out some of the moisture from the soil, but also keep the structure in good order as well, because this is the third year of no-till on this field. The other thing that we wanted to do as well is have the conditions that we could drill into in mid-October as well, specifically for blackgrass control. And so the key bit for us was making sure we had good structure and we weren't drilling into a wet mess. And this is what we're sort of finding with these short-term cover crops. This is a mixture of rye, mustard and some phacelia. We're companion cropping the oilseed rape, which has got buckwheat, phacelia and bursin clover, and then we also make up some of our own mixes, so it's based around spring oats grow on the farm. The key bit for us is that you know, having the conditions to be able to actually sort of drill into in that back end of October is the key, because it's all very well being, you know, pushing that drilling window back, but you've got to have the conditions you can drill into at the same time. It's doing great stuff structurally immediately. In terms of nutrient capture, it's doing a job, but in terms of a direct return to the crop afterwards, probably not at that stage, but for the longer term view, it is probably paying itself back.